So welcome your first debater for Team Sharks, Bob Powers!
Thank you, Matthew. I don't remember the words to the Super Bowl shuffle because me, an entire generation of people, tried to blot it out of our memory. It's a generational shame, and it shouldn't be praised as a value. We don't want it to come back. Hi, everybody. Now, I thought I was going to come out here and just sling a bunch of slams at Bears tonight, just like about their many humiliating shortcomings. Like how they're the only animal so stupid you can trick them into not killing you by pretending you died of natural causes right in front of their eyes. How the movie Cocaine Bear taught me to play dead whenever a friend texts me who told me that I should go see Cocaine Bear. How bears can't agree on a dress code except while appealing to children when they all decide to go with scantily clad. But before getting into the jokes, I feel like we do need to take a serious moment to remember all of those innocent souls who tragically lost their lives to bear attacks between the years 1784 and present day. As compiled by Wikipedia, please bow your heads. You get it. There's a lot of them. There's a lot of them. And I'm not going to go through the whole list and relitigate every single gruesome bear murder. We only have the hall for another hour before Meg Wolitzer breaks down the door and makes someone read an Alice Munro story. So we got to move along. Given the huge volume of bear attacks, it would almost make more sense to, like, pay attention and try to figure out all those instances when bears weirdly and suspiciously didn't attack somebody. So let's do that, shall we? Where are the places that have, for some reason, been spared from ursine wrath? Ursine? Show of hands. Okay. Where are they? There aren't that many, but they are notable. For example, Justice Samuel Alito's house. Zero bear attacks. Why? Why would bears respect the safety of the people in this house but maul the rest of us indiscriminately? Maybe that upside down flag means a little more than we think. You might say, oh, Mrs. Alito, she's just bickering with her neighbors. Do not play dumb with me because I always win dumb. Maybe it was less of a signal to the neighbors than it was a signal alerting bears that the lady in this house shares their general political worldview and they should go find dinner elsewhere. It's the only way to explain it that I can see. Okay, who else has been mysteriously spared? Eric Trump. Zero bear bites. I'm sorry, say what you will about this man, but he looks delicious. His gums alone could fill every plate at a Thanksgiving table, and the meat on him would be decadent, the kind of tender, melt-in-your-mouth flesh that you feel awful eating because you just know it's from some immoral practice. Foie gras, veal, tiny cages, filled like funnels down the throat. You know that's the only way you could get something that yielding. There is no way that bears could resist that kind of mouthfeel. And nothing could keep them from tearing into that man's throat. Unless they think that throat adds an important voice to the discourse. Okay, where else has there never been a bear attack? Oh, look at that, Jeffrey Epstein's jet, the Lolita Express. Zero bear attacks. This plane flew everywhere. You expect me to believe no bears ever considered barging onto this plane, mauling everyone on the manifest? Well, you expect me wrong. It would have been so easy for a bear to charge into that cabin, knock Malcolm Gladwell and Bill Clinton and master illusionist David Copperfield off their massage tables, tossing Bill Gates and Steven Pinker and Matt Groening onto the waterbed so it could rush Jeffrey Epstein and finally, deservedly tear him limb from limb. But for some reason, the bears let him go. I'm just thinking maybe, just maybe, the CIA wasn't the only organization protecting him. This is a good time to note, if I die in the near future, it wasn't a suicide. It was bears. And yes, there are shark attacks, but their attacks fall on the right side of things politically and historically. How do we know? This statistic proves it. Shark attacks in the U.S. are concentrated in Florida. They are doing the work to shrink the Republican base faster than Ron DeSantis' COVID policies. Now, all right, while these acts of mercy are notable and they're extremely troubling, there is one attack we should highlight. Perhaps the most tragic example of what can happen if you develop any kind of sympathy or affection for these monsters. I am talking, of course, about Timothy Treadwell, the bear lover whose death was chronicled in the Werner Herzog masterpiece, Grizzly Man. Oh shit, did any of you see this movie? Oh, okay, good, thank God. But you're, okay. All right, Treadwell loves bears, but bears fear intimacy, so they killed him for it. Now, if you saw this movie, so I want to play this one memorable scene from the movie where Werner and Treadwell's friend Jewel discuss the very last video found on Treadwell's camera after his fatal bear attack. I know it's hard, but we have to watch this.
Truly, you must never listen to this.
I know, Werner. I'm never going to.
I think you should not keep it. You should destroy it.
Yeah.
I think that's what you should do.
But they didn't destroy it. In fact, tonight, we're finally going to see the footage. We can't turn away from this anymore. We are going to see the footage that was on that tape that had these people so shaken. Here it is, the very last thing Timothy Treadwell saw before he died.
Down, set, yikes! No one likes a bath tissue that leaves pieces behind. That's where there's Charmin Ultra Strong.
No one likes a bath tissue that leaves pieces behind.
Every time a bell rings, a bear attack victim goes to heaven. Authorities claim Treadwell was murdered by bears, but considering what he had to look at in his final moments, I think we can assume it was a suicide. Thank you very much.